Scientists scour the most severe places on Earth, hoping to uncover life clinging on the edge of habitability. These expeditions have revealed strange life forms surviving in extreme conditions, giving hope to the idea that life can survive the extreme conditions of alien worlds.
One of the great questions associated with this is, if there's heat and there's water, could there also possibly be life? On the Earth, when you have heat and water, you often have life. These creatures tenaciously cling to their ecological niches.
The gas giant of Jupiter is the largest planet in our solar system. 5 times the distance from the Sun than our own planet, Jupiter is a freezing, ghostly hell of swirling gases with no water for life. In its orbit, however, are many moons, some of which have environments like places on Earth. Io, the moon closest to the gas giant, has hundreds of active volcanoes.
Io is an amazing place where there are volcanoes exploding, but there's no water on Io, and the chemicals are not the chemicals that anybody believes can be made into life. Now, someone once said, well, that's because your mind's not flexible enough. But trying to imagine something living in an exploding volcano is pretty hard.
But another moon of Jupiter tells a different story. Europa is the 4th largest moon in the Jupiter system and orbits just beyond Io. The exact opposite of that volcanic moon, Europa's surface temperatures dive 250 degrees below freezing. The lunar surface's granite-hard ice makes it seem no more than a barren snowball in space. But scientists know better than to judge a moon by its cover. In 1996, a NASA probe named Galileo closed in on Europa, taking high-resolution images of the surface. These photos reveal a vast interlocking pattern of cracks and fissures in the ice. Since no craters dot the surface, scientists know that the surface is relatively new.
It was Galileo who mapped Europa from top to bottom and let us understand that it looks a lot like the Arctic Sea during winter. And scientists now are convinced that there is a water ocean underneath the surface of Europa. The linear features represent cracks in the ice from the regular pounding of the inside, this ocean moving back and forth under the gravitational influence of Jupiter.
The enticing possibility of a liquid water ocean beneath Europa has brought Kevin Hand to a seemingly opposite environment. Under the searing sun of Kenya, super salty waters wash along the edges of Lake Magadi.
How do we even think we know that there's this massive global ocean on Europa? One of the most compelling ways in which we can figure out that beneath the surface ice of Europa there lies this vast ocean has to do with the conductivity of that ocean. And part of the reason that I'm here has to do with this stuff. All this white that you're seeing is salt. Now, this water here is full of salt, dissolved salt. When you dissolve salt in water, you make that water conductive. If you have salt dissolved in water, you then have a conductor. And that's exactly what the Galileo spacecraft detected.
In 2000, Galileo scanned the frozen moon and confirmed that underneath its icy surface was an electrically charged layer, an enormous conduit for electromagnetic interaction. This charged layer could only be salty water. This was confirmation of a vast reservoir deep inside the moon.
So that's one of the most important and most interesting lines of evidence for this global subsurface salty liquid water ocean. When you think about the search for life elsewhere, liquid water is a key ingredient, a key requirement. This vast body of liquid water is incredibly exciting and intriguing in our search for life beyond Earth.
But a high-tech probe would have to drill through miles of ice to find out. Such an overwhelming and costly project would require reasonable evidence that life could thrive in Europa's subsurface oceans. But there's at least one scientist who thinks there's another way to find such evidence.
It might be possible to remotely sense evidence for life even before we have the ability to land on the surface of Europa and take samples.
Richard Hoover is an astrobiologist with NASA. He is ready to shed light on potential life in Europa by heading to the underground, to a dark ice tunnel in remote Alaska. In the sunless underworld of Fox Tunnel, he wants to excavate life beneath the ice.
This is one of the neatest places on Earth. Here in Alaska, in the Fox permafrost tunnel, it looks like an alien world. But we're actually taking a step backward in time. This is truly spectacular. These ice wedges were formed approximately 35,000 years ago. And in this period, the great woolly mammoths, saber-toothed tigers, these animals were roaming the surface of the Earth. It is truly a time machine. On the ice of Europa, the conditions would be somewhat similar to what we have here in the Fox Tunnel.
In this dark cavern, Richard can really see what grows deep under the ice. His ultraviolet lamp brings to light the living creatures colonizing the ice in vast communities.
Although there may be skeptics that would think it would be impossible for life to exist here in the total darkness at minus 4°C, we see in the ultraviolet light the pigmentation of the living organisms. What's there is alive and growing.
The pigments of these tough microbes react to this special UV light. Richard's method could be a new way to detect life on Europa.
It is quite exciting because if, in fact, we can use this technique in the ice on Earth, then using very high-intensity ultraviolet lasers, it may be possible to stimulate biological pigments, if they are present, in the ice of Europa.
Not only has Richard found life in conditions like those on Europa, he's shown that UV detection built for a future mission could expose life's vital signs without drilling to Europa's watery underworld. If we detect a biological hotspot, Richard thinks there may even be a way to collect living samples from Europa. At the Matanuska Glacier of Alaska, he tests his theory.
The polar ice caps of Earth give us a place where we can study microorganisms that live within ice and survive being frozen within ice for long periods of time.
Richard's excavations undermine the basic assumptions about life.
It had been thought for a great period of time that life couldn't exist in ice, but it was discovered that there were microorganisms that were present in the deep ice, many of which were alive even though they had been frozen in the ice for the order of 100,000 years.
Incredibly, these microorganisms can be resurrected when thawed.
Well, when I thawed out the ice and looked in and saw these bacteria swimming, it was very, very clear that this was a tremendously exciting find. There are a large number of microorganisms alive in this bag.
This shows how microscopic life might also exist in Europa's rock-solid ice.
It may be possible to obtain evidence for life by just going to the surface and taking samples of the ice, very much like what we did here on the Matanuska Glacier, without actually drilling through the ice and going into the oceans below.
Microorganisms might be perfectly preserved, possibly even living, inside Europa's ice.
There are skeptics that feel that the idea of life beyond the planet Earth is extremely controversial, but many times these skeptics are not microbiologists.
Richard's technique of bringing life to light could one day solve the mystery of life on Europa, provided it's actually there.